Welcome to ISRK interaction session. So basically, let me introduce ISRK first. ISRK is a voluntary support group for all Indians and researchers in Korea organized for educational research, jobs, social and community service purposes. Our mission is to establish the largest community of India student in researcher in Korea. With strong engagement and interaction opportunities, our vision is to promote a better life for our Indian student and researcher in Korea. So this is our today's speaker, ISRK live interaction session, Brain Pool Program for Postdoctoral Fellowship. So our today's speaker are Dr. Pooja Rawat. She's a postdoc fellow doing a PDF in Kyunghee University. She joined the Kyare Fellowship in 2019 and finished her PhD from Delhi University, India. Next speaker is Dr. Muhammad Wasim Hussain. He's also a postdoc fellow in Hanyang University, a brain pool fellow from 2020 in Korea. He did his PhD from ISAB Bhopal, India. So another speaker is Dr. Monu Verma. Postdoc in University of Seoul and joined KRF Fellowship in 2019 and he did his PhD from IIT Roorkee, India. So this is our today's speaker session. And then after finishing the interaction session with our speaker, we will have our next question and answer session in last. And this is our next session with the ISRK interaction for the university and professors funded Brain Korea Fellowship on 27 March. So stay tuned for more information. So let's start. I would like to introduce Dr. Pooja here. Dr. Pooja.
Thank you, ISRK, for giving me chance so that I can introduce the KRF Fellowship, which is now a brain pool fellowship. I am Dr. Pooja Rawat. I have completed my PhD from Delhi University in material science. After that, I have also taught in Amity University for 1.5 years. And then I have applied for KRF and got the KRF. And right now I am a postdoc fellow in Kyunghee University, Korea. Now I will share my screen so that I can introduce the recently announced Brain Pool and Brain Pool Plus Fellowship. What are the eligibilities? What are the fellowship you will get? All the details I will show you and I will tell you. Okay, hope it is coming clearly to all of you. So from, till 2020, we are having a KRF and a brain pool program from our NRF, National Research Foundation. But from 2021, now the KRF and brain pool program stop. And we are having with recent guidelines, brain pool and the brain pool plus program. The basically idea of releasing this Brain Pool and Brain Pool Plus program is the same. First, to introduce or to promote outstanding overseas researcher so to come to Korea and do their best research. Second, to establish a long-term relationship between the industries and the research institutes. So there are three major fields in which you guys can apply for the Brain Pool and the Brain Pool Plus. First is your strategic investment industries. Second, your industrial technology. And third is your innovative growth. Or I can say that basically there are total 24 research fields in which you guys can apply for the Brain Pool and Brain Pool Plus. Now I will start with the Brain Pool. What are the eligibility for the Brain Pool? The first and the foremost eligibility is this fellowship is only for the student, PhD student outside the South Korea. I will highlight this line that you should be outside the South, those PhD students who are outside the South Korea, only they can apply. Secondly, for Brain Pool, which they have done for 2021 only. Like if you guys don't have a PhD, those students can also apply, but they should have a total five year R&D experience. If you guys having a 5 year research and R&D experience without a PhD, you guys can apply for the Brainpool Fellowship. Now in Brainpool, they have divided into two parts, a type one and a type two, or you can say a short term and a long term. Like in a short term, you will have a 3 to 12 month duration. 3 to 12 months, you can say like you can come for 3 months also, you can come for 6 months also, and you can come for 12 months. But the maximum limit is 1 year, like 12 months. While for type two, it's a long-term support. Long-term support means 2+1. First, you will get for a 2 years. After that, you can extend for the 1 year. Although in their guidelines, they have said that it can be extended to 5 years if your research output will be highly encourageable. So you guys can be extended till 5 years. If we will see the personal cost means it will include your fellowships and other expenses. So it can be your 5 to 25 million Korean won. Other expenses, it means when you will select it and you will come to the Korea, your airfare, your insurance, your moving expenses, and your business travel. Other than that, if you are applying for any conference, all other things will be covered by the NRF and you can say your brain pool. After that, you will have a 5 million Korean won. This 5 million Korean won is your indirect cost. That indirect cost totally for your, and you can say some, your assistant who will do all your paperwork and all other stuff. Or you can say a Korean assistant who will do all other your extra stuff. For that, they have given the 5 million Korean won per year. And the next is your host institute. For applying a brain pool, first you have to search a host professor, and that host professor should be from a government funded at any public research institute, or if it is related to industry also, you can apply through that professor, or that professor will apply for you in the brain pool program. And after that, the selection will come, then only you guys can come to the Korea. This is eligible for both type one and type two. First, you have to search a host professor. Then the host professor for you will apply for a brain pool program. So this one is for your brain pool. The next fellowship is your, okay, in this case also, one main important point which I want to tell you, like if you will feel like you can apply, you want to like both, like if you want, you will see like, okay, we will come for three months or 4 months, then we want to extend it. It is not possible. It means your host professor can apply only for one type. If he is applying for type one, then your limit is 12 months. After that, it will be finished. But and if he is applying for type two, then your limit will be 2+1. So you have to make sure which type you want to apply. The next one is your Brainpool Plus. Okay, Brainpool Plus is also for the Korean nationals, but that is also an overseas Korean residence or a ethnic Korean or a foreign nationals is there. But this fellowship is also valid for Koreans, but that should be a overseas Korean residence. Second, the same, a PhD student means a doctorate and or a industry person, but he should have a 5 year experience. The Brainpool Plus fellowship is a long-term fellowship, means up to 10 years. But the duration will be 2+3+3+2. And total support, you will get about 600 million Korean won per year. You guys will feel like a 600 million Korean won is little bit very less. But in this case, in Brainpool Plus, you will have like this one. In Brainpool Plus, the main thing is your salary will be given by the research institute. Means where you will search a host professor and the host professor will apply. So that research institute will give you your salary, whatever be the salary for a full-time employer. But other than that salary, this 600 million won will divide it, and some extra money from this 600 million won will also be included in your personal cost. So all total will be equivalent to a normal professor. So it's quite high. Other than that, same like a brain pool. In brain pool plus also, you will get your airfare, your moving expenses, your conference participation, your insurance, everything you will get. And your HRA. HRA means your living expenses. And in this, in case of brain pool plus, your HRA is almost 12 million Korean won per year. So almost 1 million Korean won per year, which is quite reasonable to stay in Korea. And talking about the host institute, it is the same for institute. It is the same as a brain pool. Like it should be a government funded, a public research institute, any university. But your host should be a dean of academic affairs. Means it's not, it can't be a normal professor, but it should hold a some head of the department position and something dean. And if you are going for an industry or a non-university research institute, then the position of the professor is equivalent to the dean of academic affairs. In case of brain pool plus, earlier what I have told you, for brain pool, you have to search your host professor and you both should write one proposal and submit. Your host professor for you will submit that proposal in the brain pool program, and later on you will be selected. That depends. But in case of brain pool plus, there are the two types of evolution. In first two steps of evolution, in first steps, first you have to submit all your whatever you want to your proposal, or you can say it's not a kind of proposal, I will say. It's a kind of form in which you will write that in which industry you are working currently. And what is your expectation, what you want to do in when you will come to the Korea, all related information you will submit. Then that information will evaluate it. And when they will feel that you are eligible, your second step is the presentation. And that presentation will be given by your host professor, but you will be also there. And there will be a question answer session. So comprehensively, after the two steps, you guys, after two steps, or they will select you. So if I will say, since this brain pool and brain pool plus is started from the 2021, I told you earlier, till 2020 you are having a KRF, but from 2021 the KRF has stopped. Now you are having a brain pool and brain pool plus. So if I will check, I think the first call deadline is already over. The second call will come from 30th April, and the third call will come in 30th June to. And the last call for this year will come in the 31st August. So you guys, please make a note of it and be aware that when these dates will come, they will announce the Brain Pool and Brain Pool Plus fellowships. Again, the same thing. If you are applying for Brain Pool, you can't apply for the Brain Pool Plus. And if you are in Brain Pool also, if you are applying for Type 1, you can't apply for the Type 2. So you should be very specific for which program you want to apply. All these are the details for the Brain Pool and Brain Pool Plus. After this, there are some points which you should be always make a note of it. First, like a Brain Pool fellow are required, like if you are got selected. So you will get a 4 month duration. And during that duration, you have to be enter the Korea. If you fail to enter the Korea in that 4 month duration, then that fellowship will end. So within the 4 months, you have to enter. Although you will feel like 4 months is a huge gap, but sometimes visa problems came and this happens. Or if something kind of stuff is happening, then you should have a reasonable reason to give to the NRF. Second, In case if you guys have applied and you got selected, and maybe some conditions and you guys are not coming to the Korea to join this program, First thing you should have again, you should have a reason, a good reason. If you guys don't have a good reason, then you and your host professor will be banned or restricted for 3 years to apply for the brain pool program. And third point, since like your project, you are selected, you came to the Korea and your project got started, but in between something happens and you want to leave without, before completing the duration, like this one is for your brain pool type 2 and a brain pool plus. And something happens, you want to leave before the duration, then in that case, you have to return your HRA, means housing allowance, whatever given from the and a brain pool or brain pool plus, that you have to return it. Last point is not that much important. It's like in case of brain pool, I have told you it's a type 1 and a type 2. Type 1 is only for your 3 to 12 months. So in case of type 1, your HRA will be given by your research institute where you will apply. And in type 2, your HRA will be the same as a brain pool plus, the 12 million Korean won. So all these are the details I have included for the brain pool and the brain pool plus fellowships. If you guys have any query, you guys can ask. Thank you, Prashant. From my side, I think it's over. So if they will have any question, they can ask. Yeah. I will be happy to conclude it.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Pooja, for your nice information and presentation. Now for the question and question and answer session, we will take the question and answers in the last of this presentation. So I would like to invite Dr. Wasim for his experience, how he applied for the fellowship. So Dr. Wasim.
Hello, good evening all. Am I audible to everyone?
Yeah.
So first of all, welcome you all to this ISRK presentation, and I'm very thankful. And also thank you, Pooja, for explaining all the details, each point to point, whatever the points are required for applying for this fellowship. Thank you very much. You made my job very easy. So, and I'm just explaining you about I'm just sharing my screen from where you can apply. So here is the web page where you can find the details of brain pool program. So here is in the news and notices section, you can find, there is a notices section where you can find the announcement for brain pool program. And here you can find all the details of the brain pool program. And as you can see here, the announcement for brain pool program for inviting outstanding scientists from overseas around second round in 2019 has been updated. And you can follow up all the procedure from here in this website. You just follow the website nrf.re.kr, and you can select the language, as most of them prefer English. There's also an option for Korean. You can select the language and you can scroll and get the information for the brain pool program. So here at the end, you can find the brain pool PDF. What are the requirements? This is brain pool 19, second call of a brain pool announcement. And this is the another one is brain pool 19. This is another second call for, these are the guidelines, what are required for the brain pool program. So according to my experience, hold a second. Okay, I have stopped now sharing the screen. So if you have any doubts, please you can ask to everyone, anyone here in this forum. So according to my experience, what was the process is I contacted my supervisor, Professor Choi, to fund me for the postdoctoral fellowship. So in that case, he suggested to apply for the postdoctoral KRF, which is now as Brainpool Fellowship, Brainpool Program. So he suggested to apply for Korean Research Fellowship. And when I followed what are the deadlines and what are the requirements, and I feel I select my topic of interest for the postdoctoral research. And I said him, I will be working on the polymer solar cells. So he said, okay, it's very interesting. Just you mention me what is the kind of work you want to work with. So he said, okay, that's good. When I submitted him a rough proposal of my research work, he said it is looking good. And in that direction, we can project. And all the procedure was been followed by professor and his team. And I have now successfully, my proposal was been accepted in Korean Research Fellowship. What I mean to take a stress on your thing is, you have to take focus on a topic where in which field you are interested, and which field is actually in connecting towards your professor's research. So if you have both the things, your interest as well as there is a good connection with your professor, and if your proposal is very good, and the professor will anyhow, he will never say no to you, and it will be beneficial for the Korean Research Foundation, and definitely it will be accepted. And my opinion will be, if you focus on the proposal writing and stress on each and every point, take a good stress on each and every point, and definitely it will be accepted. And now I will hand over to Dr. Monu Verma to convey his message according to his experience. Dr. Prashant, can you please?
Thank you, Dr. Vaseem, for your wonderful explanation about your experience, how you approached for the KRF Fellowship. So I would like to invite Dr. Verma. Dr. Verma.
Hello, are you listening to me?
Yeah, yeah.
Good evening to everyone. And thanks to Prashant, Pooja, and to all of you for providing me this chance to discuss about my past time here. And during this time when I applied here, I just have only 12 days. So instantly I just search on Google to my professor related to my field, and on Google and ResearchGate and some papers related to my fields. So I just found some professors and communicate to them. And so that they first, my priority was to say yes from their sides. So immediately they just said, yes, I'm doing work on your field, but what is your opinion? What do you want to do this one? So my work that was related to some special issues, means wastewater related issues. So he just say yes. So we just finished within 4 days our proposal, and little bit help was done by Dr. Pooja Rawat. And then we applied. And immediately after 1.5 months, I think results was announced and I got my fellowship. And one more thing, I think KRF or Brainpool Fellowship, if you are getting, it is not a typical fellowship. It is not typical, truly speaking. Before me, I know many students who just publish only 2 papers or 3 papers during PhD, otherwise during PhD and after PhD. And even they just found this fellowship. You cannot believe this one. So it is not typical task. There are many things related to achieve this position. First, I think your proposal, your competency, what will be the outcome of your proposals, that they are important thing. Second thing, your professor and your institute, how they are. If these 4 things are a good one, then definitely 100%, I think anyone can find this position. I'm sure 100%. And main advantage of this position, suppose if you are doing postdoc fellows under some professor, so maybe he will give you some pressure related to your work or this one. But if you have your own fellowship, this is Brainpool Fellowship, so even your professor, he will give too much respect to you and he will consider you as a professor. And maybe everyone, you should apply for this position, means Brainpool Fellowship. And definitely you will find. That is very easy. Nothing within 1 week you can write proposal and everything, whatever you need for during application, this one. Thank you.
Yeah.
If,
thank you,
if
Dr.
you have anything,
Manu,
then you can discuss me. Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Manu, for your explanation and about research proposal and how to choose the professor as per your research expertise. Now I will go to the Q&A session. I would like to ask if you have like any kind of questions related to how to apply for the fellowship and how to make a research proposal about the KRF and Brain Pool Fellowship. So most welcome. If there is any question, you can ask.
Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah, Faisal.
Yeah, so this question is with Pooja.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, so I'm already working in Korea this time.
Okay.
And so probably I'll be finishing up with my current project. And I don't know, if I don't get any new project, probably I'll be moving back to India. And hopefully I'll be applying from there. But I mean, my question is regarding your Brain Pool Plus. You know, like fellowship. I'm not very sure about from your presentation. You specifically told that Korean residents who are living outside Korea can apply. Is there any possibility that any other nationality who are not anyhow related to Korea can apply to this Brain Pool Plus? Or is it like for Indians we can only apply for Brain Pool and not Brain Pool Plus?
I think I have shown you, like, if you are in Korea, you are not being, means Indian or any national, if you are in Korea, you are not eligible for applying Brain Pool or Brain Pool Plus. Korean residents,
yeah,
I have said, but Korean residents,
yeah,
also I have said that is overseas, means they are also not to be in Korea.
Now let me frame my question again.
Yes.
Yeah. The question is, do a person who is living outside Korea, say if I am there in India,
okay,
and I have to apply among these two, Brain Pool and Brain Pool Plus, am I eligible to apply for Brain Pool Plus?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
So it is
from
not only limited
PhD?
To Korea.
From where?
I'm from IIT Kanpur.
Okay, you can apply.
No. So it's not only limited to Korean nationals. The Brain Pool Plus.
Yeah. It's not limited to only Korean national. You guys can also apply. But you guys should not
Thank
be
you.
In Korea.
That is quite evident. Yeah, I understand that.
Yeah,
the question
yeah.
was that, I was much more confused in between the Brain Pool and Brain Pool Plus because that was not demarcating, because that was the only one where you specifically said the Korean nationals living outside Korea.
Yeah,
can
actually,
apply.
In case not, of not. Brain Pool, they have restricted Korean national, but in case of Brain Pool Plus, since it's a long-term fellowship, so they have included Korean also, but that Korean should be an overseas residence. And in the second step, I have shown that a doctorate or an industrial person outside the Korea can apply for that, for Brain Pool Plus.
Yeah, that is quite clear. Thank you so much for the presentation.
Okay. Welcome.
So good evening. This is Dr. Anil. Am I audible to you?
Yeah, Dr. Anil. Please go ahead.
Yes. Good evening. So I am Dr. Anil. I did my PhD from Incheon National University, Incheon.
Okay.
Okay. So now I am working as an assistant professor in India. I am from Karnataka. I am as an assistant working as an assistant professor. It's like a permanent position here for me.
Okay.
So apart from BK Brain Pool and Brain Pool 21, so am I eligible can I get like a sabbatical research experience to any one of the universities? Is it any possible like that?
Your PhD is from Korea, but now
yeah.
you are an permanent. You are holding a permanent position in India, so
yeah,
I
but
think you can apply for Brain Pool Plus.
Brain Pool Plus. Permanent, even though it is permanent position here.
You can't say a permanent position in Korea. But it's a long term.
No, I am having a permanent position in India.
Okay, yes. You will.
So apart from also, I can apply for BK21, Brain Pool.
Yeah, you can apply, but for that, the university in which you have a permanent position, that should give you permission. But I know about the Indian rules. I think that university will give you permission that you can go for 2 years or 3 years in Korea for the research. Then you can apply. Because then you will apply for that Brain Pool Plus. That Brain Pool Plus guys will also ask you some documents. Like you will get the permission from your university that I want to go for 2 years or 3 years for research.
Like a no objection certificate from the university.
Yeah. It's a kind of no objection certificate. Since you are having a permanent position.
Apart from that, am I also apply for like sabbatical research, like 1 year? 1 year?
1 year. For one year, it's like a Brain Pool type one.
Okay.
Like, but since your PhD is from Korea, and how much is the duration? Means from PhD to your professorship?
PhD is like almost like 4 years.
4 years. Last time when I have filled the KRF, it's like this year they have not shown for Brain Pool, but I can tell you my experience when I have filled the KRF, it's like from PhD to 5 years.
Okay.
Means, there is a 5 year duration. If you have completed 5 years, then you can't apply for that KRF. So I believe like the same will be for Brain Pool also. Like if your PhD and now if you are applying and you are completing a 5 years, then you are not eligible. But since you are saying it's 4 years, so I think you should apply and you should try at least.
Okay.
Yeah, and you should try for, if you want a for less duration, you should try for Brain Pool. Brain Pool type 1. That is only for 12 months.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, sir. And one more thing I will tell you. I have told in my presentation also. If you will apply for Brain Pool Plus and Brain Pool Type 2, although you will get little bit higher pay scale, but restriction will come. Like you can't leave the position before 12 months. While in Type 1, you will not have that restriction. So whenever you want to come back, you can come. So I think you should apply Type 1.
Okay. Is it possible to share your presentation?
I think it will be uploaded in YouTube later on.
Will be uploaded in your YouTube. Then you can go to like Telegram group and we will share there.
Yeah, if you have any other question, you can ask anytime.
Okay, thank you. No, thank you.
I would like to ask one question to our KRF fellow. That one person is asking how to find a host guide. So anyone can explain about that?
Okay, in that case, I will be doing that.
Okay.
So mostly what I would suggest you is you find a professor who is in your field or your field of interest. Okay. And you just contact them through mail and tell them whether he's capable to take you as a PDF student. He has funds or not. So if it is possible, he can take you as a postdoctoral fellow in from his funding. But if not, he can, if he is interested, he will definitely ask you whether you should apply for KRF or Brain Pool Fellowship. So if he suggests to apply you for KRF or Brain Pool Fellowship, then you can go and just search for Brain Pool Fellowship and get all the details and you apply. But in that case, you have to focus on the proposal. The proposal should be having both interlink between your research and your professor research. And it should be projected in such a way that your all 2 to 3 years experience means of your work should come in that whole project year, term. So in that case, I believe if you can do write a good proposal and make it a schematic of 2 to 3 year term, what you will be doing here in 2 to 3 year, and what will be the benefit the professor will be getting from you, that will be more important.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Vasim.
Yeah, I would like to add one more point. You have to find a professor, supervisor of your field of interest from any university from Korea. There are many universities, and you have to find a professor of your field of interest.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. I have one more question. I'm yes, Dr. Daniel. I'm holding a permanent position in one of the CSER labs in India. My area of field is structural engineering. I'm a married person, and what about that? Will the institute be able to support dependent persons of me? Is there any other steps which I have to follow for bringing my dependent persons?
Right. Here in the Brainpool Fellowship, there is an opportunity that Pooja has discussed, that if you are coming with your dependables, they will be supported from the funding itself. There is still a chance from Pooja. Can you?
Yes, I will tell you. Dependable means like your children. Not for your wife, but your kids. Education of your kids will be financial by the KRF or the Brainpool and Brainpool Plus. But in this, again, I will highlight, you can tell me in which class your kids are, because they will only
just born.
I think then they can be financed, but because they have said like elementary, till elementary school only, they will finance your kids' education. But on top, on other, you can say after elementary, it will not be financed. But kindergarten, okay. It means your kids is very, it's like 1-2 years, like kindergarten and the elementary school. It will be financed, it will be supported. But more than above the elementary, it will not be.
Okay, but I can still bring my wife and the children.
Visa
process will not be a problem, right?
Visa process will not be a problem, but then your wife can also go for a job or something else.
Yes. After moving there, we can plan something.
Yes.
Please do help us, like if it is materialized, you know, we will surely in touch with you.
Definitely.
This all presentation is for your help only.
It's a very nice assembly, right? You know, thanks a lot for everyone for contacting me.
One more thing, that earlier question which is Vasim has answered, like host professor, searching a host professor. So I believe, like, you can if you will say write a mail to a host professor and he will tell you you can apply for a KRF. Better than that, directly tell that you want to apply for the KRF, and for that you want that person to be a host for you. For you, that person should be a host. So maybe there is a chance will increase, because there may be a that professor will not have funding. So he will say, sorry, I don't have funding, because I got that replies. So I have started, like, I just directly write to the professor that I want to apply for the KRF and I want you be a host for me. And you will not believe, my first mail, he got the answer, okay, I can be a host for you and you can apply for the KRF. So yeah. I think it will be more chance to get a host professor early if you will directly write that you want to apply for the Brainpool or Brainpool Plus. For this, you should have a one proposal with you.
Okay. But another problem what I faced, like when I surf to the college websites or university websites, it doesn't look similar to what we have in India. Like in India we can very clearly find out who the HOD is, and
it will be
is very difficult, it's very,
and
different.
Sometimes you will find in Korean also.
It's very, in fact, difficult to boil down to one. We are unable to finalize the area of the professor also, so that is slightly difficult to
In that case, you can try this also. When you will read the paper, you will find the authors, or you can just write your research topic, paper related your research topic, and publish in Korea. I used to do that. So you will find a Korean researcher or a Korean professor. From there, you can directly contact that professor. Just you will time, also no? have like, a similar.
We'll have some, we may have to do some homework from India and then only we can.
Yes.
<touch with them.
laughs> That homework is important, really.
All right. Yeah. Sure. Sure. That's right. That's great.
Hello. Hello. My question is to Wasim regarding the contacting the superbug. And I would like to thank you all the people and for this initiative. I am Ran Khan from IIT Kanpur. I did my PhD from Earth Sciences. So question is that in Earth Sciences, people just choose some locations for geological sampling and other. So one should can contact. Means I am from India, so I can contact. I plan my proposal according to choose a study area in India. So this is suitable or not?
Can you please come again? Because half of that your question I did not follow.
Actually, I am saying that I am from Earth Sciences, and in Earth Sciences, people work on outcrop, means geological point of collect rock samples and sediment samples and other things. So one can choose their host country as a study area for that research proposal. They will feel, means supervisor or hosting guide will comfortable for that, or they just want to choose their Korean,
in case of communicating, I believe that whatever you have your field, and you can communicate with them. You can communicate with the professor and tell what is your idea, and in which field you want to work, and you have to show them what kind of you have to show them through proposal. So how you can complete the work and how you can complete the term. With that research and how you can add to their research, you have to show them that. So whatever you have your field of interest, you just talk to the supervisor here in Korea and tell them this is your idea idea and this kind of proposal you would be like to working on.
And it is it should be clearly mentioned that I am interested to apply for that in very first month. And these programs, Brain Pool or Brain Pool Plus.
Yeah. You can mention that one. You can mention that one. You would be willing to apply for Brain Pool or Brain Pool Plus.
Yeah. Thank you.
Right.
Thank
you. Hello, Dr. Vishnu.
Yes, please.
My doubt, another doubt is like, there are totally 4 calls, right? First call, second call, and third call, and fourth call. For each call, they will be announcing the results separately, or for throughout the year, they will announce only one time the result.
Dr. Pooja, can you please answer?
Yes, I will answer it. It's like your first call. So they have said like there will be a first call and people have applied. If the total number of seats are still vacant, then only second call will come.
Then are there any limitation on number of candidates they will be selecting?
Yeah, it is depend on the proposal. Whatever proposal will submit it, and they will see if they will feel like you they are having a more seats, so they will announce the second call. But if the number of people already more in first call, then there may be a chances that second call will not come. Then there will be a third call.
Oh, they may skip the second call. So they may announce the third call alone.
Yeah, the third call will come. I think it's the same like earlier it's in KRF. KRF also comes in 2 times in a year. Similarly, Brain Pool will also be like, they have just divided first call and second call and like third call and fourth call.
Okay, but is there any number of student limitation for a specific university? Because there are a number of universities, so host professors will be there. If there are two or four professors hosting for a Brain Pool Fellowship, and the other university does not have any professor, so how do they match for
this? See, for this, they have not given any written rule. They have not given any written
for
rule.
For this, I think only one thing matter is your proposal.
Proposal, yes. At last, the thing which will be matter, your proposal.
You have to pay much more attention to your proposal and focus on that. And if you project in such a way that it's a brilliant proposal, then I think no one will stop you to get this fellowship.
No, during just one second. I want to discuss something here.
Yeah.
Not your proposal. What are your outcome competency? That is important thing in your proposal. That will include your 15th part and your professor, your host institute, because they will include 100 marks in including everything. So every part is necessary and important for your brain pool fellowship. So please focus on every point. Doesn't matter because your proposal that includes only 15 marks, and your host that will I think include 10 or 15 marks, and your competency means what will be the output or outcome of your proposal that will also that include also 15 marks. So everything is important for your proposal. And one more thing, someone asking about application. You should have original PhD degree. You cannot apply with provisional degree. Otherwise, they will exclude you in review committee from review committee.
I have one doubt.
First, number one. Yeah.
I have only one doubt. Can I interrupt?
Yeah.
Yeah. See, I have a PhD degree from IIT Madras. I did a research on structural engineering. But at present, I am working on the corrosion aspect of reinforced structures. Okay. But if I'm applying for postdoc, I have to write the proposal on the research content based on my PhD experience or the area in which I'm working now, because I don't have any papers on the area in which I'm working now. So if all my publications are with respect to my PhD research, but does that matter?
Yeah. So I think you should apply in your PhD field. Because if you have some papers in your current working field, then you can apply. And here, one important thing, because brain pool, they involve 24 research fields. Pooja, I'm right?
Yes, 24 fields. Total 24.
So please correlate your work at least one of your this field. Otherwise, if you will directly write your proposal, otherwise your field will not match with them. They definitely will exclude your proposal.
So I have to
focus on your work with this one.
All right. Yeah.
Especially materials, advanced material or energy related, because if someone or other fields are related to you, then you can apply in that one.
Oh. It's like a material is also a broad. Yeah. You have to choose a specific topic and that topic related to the 24 fields which they have said, like you can apply in that 24 field. And your question is like you're having a paper in PhD, but currently in which you are working, you don't have paper.
Yeah, I'm working on it. I'm working towards it, but
it's okay. So you want to apply for the topic in which currently you are working, or you want to go for
I don't PhD? Know for which they will be giving weightage. If they look for my previous publications, that will not match with my proposal what I will be submitting based on my current research.
So continue,
that mismatch is there, no?
In continue to that, I would like to say something. So my field was not in development of polymer solar cell, but still I am working here as polymer solar cell. It only depends on your proposal. So if you are capable and if you say how you can interlink your research with the postdoctoral research here in Korea, then no one can stop you in that case.
Okay.
So I feel that it is possible that you can change your research field, but you have to show your tendency. You have to show you can work in various different fields.
Yes.
Right.
I have to prove my competency. Yes.
Right. Exactly.
Pooja, we are unable to hear you.
Hello, Dr. Vaseem. Hello.
Yes, please.
Yeah, this is Santosh Ravichandran. In my case, the proposal, everything was ready for the brain pool program and the professor, everything was ready. Unfortunately, I didn't get my main degree, only I had my provisional degree. So currently I'm right now in Korea for the past 1 week under quarantine period, and I'm about to join Hanyang University as a university postdoctoral fellow. am okay. I eligible to apply now in just 1 week time, because I'll be receiving my main degree in just 2 days? Right. So I am I eligible?
So in that case, you have to provide them that confidence.
Original degree.
You know, that is okay, but you have to provide them the confidence from your supervisor that you will be getting your degree by your proposal getting approval, by the time your proposal gets approval.
But right now I am under quarantine in Korea. Right now I am in Korea. I am about to join in 1 week Hanyang University under a university postdoctoral fellowship.
Okay, then I think I have also done the same way, because my degree was not yet come because of the lockdown and no convocation. So I have not received my degree. But in that case, I provided them the information that I have provided them the provisional degree, and I have provided a letter from the institute that my term is completed from my institute. So I have provided them
during when they will review your document, they will ask you also from your professor about your original degree. Can you send me this degree? Even scan copy is sufficient, no matter if you have original degree or no.
Okay, but presently I am in Korea under quarantine. So will I be able to apply?
Yeah, you can apply. Because you are in Korea, so you cannot apply. If you will be outside of Korea, then you can apply. Because they make these restrictions now.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I would like to ask one question. One person is asking, my PhD thesis in material chemistry, but my defense is pending. Can I apply without awarding degree?
No. I think no, because in India, the defense trend is different. So we never know what will be the defense timing. So that definitely not no. If you have completed your defense and then, or you have any provisional degree, that can be a possible. There is a possibility that you can get it approved from your institute. So
no,
I have
no.
I have done that.
I am 100% sure. No. They need original degree, because last time my one colleague, he applied and everything have been finished, but they did not accept their provisional degree and their letter from IIT Roorkee even. Okay. They just ask original degree, and otherwise his KRF that was accepted, but they at last moment they just rejected. They said just we need original degree. Provisional degree, I think, please don't waste your time with provisional degree. Just search some professor and then find your original degree and then apply. So provisional degrees, no, they will not ask. They will not accept. Maybe 100%.
Yeah, the condition is stringent now. So you have to follow the rules.
Yeah, there's one more question. Is there any requirement criteria in terms of paper to apply for the KRF or BP?
No.
So is there any, like, what how much minimum paper you should have, like?
No. As Prasant, as I told you during session, maybe there is no restriction for your papers. If you have two papers, maybe, otherwise even you have one paper, maybe that depends upon your proposal, especially you can get, and you have 7 papers, 10 papers or 15 papers and your proposal is not good, maybe that may be rejected. So publication doesn't matter, but yeah, if you have some good publications in ACS or RSC or Science Direct, doesn't matter, means good impact factor. So your possibility of acceptance, that is going to be increased.
Increased, right.
Yeah.
Means you should have a good, publication in terms of, like, you have one, that will be enough for...
one paper, two paper, enough, no worry. But
you should have
your proposal, that should be good.
Yeah,
and your paper, that should be also be good. Because I know some KRF students, they just have two papers and not even have a good impact factor, 2.5 or 3 nearly about. And they just got, but that is old time, before 3 years or 2 years. But now there is two competition, so because of competition, some discrimination that is going to be increased. So you should have some good one. That's it.
Hello.
Yeah.
This is Imran. So my question is, I have PhD from Korea. So am I eligible for BP type 2?
No.
No.
But no. I haven't seen this condition in their requirement, in their guidelines.
They are asking for overseas postdoctoral research. So
no,
you can apply, but maybe you should first join some university or college in India and then take some certificate from that side, and then you can apply from India. Then otherwise, if you are working here, doesn't matter, you are in PhD or postdoc, you cannot apply now.
Just in Korea, you cannot apply. From Korea, you cannot apply.
Currently, I'm in India, but my PhD is from Korea.
No, that is possible. So, that is possible. You can apply from there.
Yeah, currently I'm in India, but I don't have any institute in India. I'm just waiting for some kind of fellowships and
that position. Is still possible. That is still possible.
Yeah, because Dr. Pooja, during her presentation, she told that the PhD should be outside Korea. So I was confused for that.
No. If you are applying from outside Korea, then it is.
Okay.
I think your mic is not working.
Ah, okay. Sorry for that. But I got my answer. Thank you very much.
Okay, thanks.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, if there is any question, then you can ask. Feel free to ask any query.
Yeah, Dr. Imran, to follow with that question, I would like to ask, like, in the brain pool application, they are asking for the affiliation of the BP candidate. So if in that case, if you are not affiliated to any of the institutes, or if you have completed your doctorate from any of the institutes around 1 month back, what will be the affiliation of the BP candidate be? Hello?
Yeah, please repeat your question, please.
Actually, in my case, I have completed my doctorate around 1 month back, okay? And right. I have received my provisional degree. So in the BP application form, they are asking for the affiliation of the BP candidate, that is brain pool candidate. What will be my affiliation be? Because you just now said that you need to get some certificates from the institute. In my case, I'll not be able to get a certificate because I have completed my doctorate.
You have completed your doctorate from where?
From Anna University, Chennai.
So it is possible to get your affiliation?
No, I have completed my doctorate, right? So I am out of the university now.
No, but you can get the information that you have completed your doctorate from there. Only after completion of your doctorate, then only you can apply for the postdoc.
Yeah, but in BP application, that is brain program application, they are asking for the current affiliation of the BP candidate. In that case, what will be the affiliation?
Your current affiliation will be your university only, from where you have done it. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
There is one question for contact professor in host institute. Is it need any research relationship between host professor and our supervisor?
No.
Mostly not required, but if you can interlink your research and your professor research, that will be more beneficial. Mostly it is not required that you have to have the same research as your professor.
Yeah.
But if you can interlink your research and your professor's research, and you can show that how you can improve the trend in the research, then it's very good. It's really beneficial.
Okay, someone is asking, it is possible to complete PDF in 3 to 4 months via BP 3 months program?
No, I think no. Pooja, is it possible? Pooja,
unmute you this one.
Oh, no, so I will answer you, Prashant. So in that case, it is not possible. Because PDF, it will, if you have to have a PDF experience, it should be at least 1 year.
So minimum criteria is like you can apply for the minimum 1 year at least.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. Now audible?
Right. Yeah. Now it is open.
Now audible?
Yeah.
Now I will tell you, in type 1, there is a chance like you can apply for 3 months. I have told you, in type 1, in brain pool, you have two types of fellowships, short term and long term.
Long term.
In short term, you can apply for 3 months, 4 months, 6 months, up to 12 months.
Up to 12 months, right?
Yeah, up to 12 months.
Pooja, you said that in that term, you should not go in between, right?
Yeah, that is brain pool type 2 and brain pool plus. I have highlighted this. It's a brain pool type 2 and brain pool plus. You can't go before 12 months. But right. Brain pool type 1 is for short term only, like 3 months, 6 months.
6 months.
Maximum is 12 months.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, then you can apply for short term.
Okay, if I am applying for type 1, say for example, I'm proposing to work for 10 to 12 months.
Okay.
Can I take a leave one time, come here to back to India and go? Is there any kind of leave which you can offer?
I think
they will not give.
Yeah,
according to Korean's rule, you will find 20 days leave after in one year. I think they will not give.
So for the complete duration, I have to be there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Or I can say, see, since it's 2021, it started, so still all rules are not clear. But okay. From my side, I feel like what Dr. Monu said, it's like 20 days, 20 working holidays for 1 year. If you will apply for 4 months, so you just divide that one, like 20 working holidays, if it is for 1 year, so how much you will get for 4 months? So there is a chance only that much holidays you can get.
Yeah.
Or secondly, you can try, like, if you want to go to India. So see, it's an opinion. Like, you can fill a conference in India, and through that conference, you can go.
Okay, that's an indirect way of availing.
Yeah, that's an indirect way.
That's a good idea. Okay,
it's an opinion. It's not any rule.
All right, I understand.
But short term, there may be a chance that they will divide. Like, there is a hard rule, like 20 working holidays you will get for 1 year. So, depend on duration which you will apply and you will get, divide that duration. And I think for 3 months, it will be 6 days or 4 days. You can divide it accordingly. Like it's a 20 working days for 12 months.
There will be funding for attending conferences outside Korea.
Yes,
you have the opportunity.
Yes, they will fund.
Okay, thank you.
They will fund your airfare also. They will fund your insurance also.
As well
and
as
even for your living expenses. Yeah, right. Your HRA. Living expenses.
Always. Super. Thank you.
But yeah, for type 1, if you will apply for type 1, your living expenses will be funded by your host institutes. So in that case, how much host institute will fund, that we don't know.
Type 2 is okay.
Yeah, type 2 is okay. But type 1, we don't know how much he will fund. Secondly, he can give you dormitory. Like dormitory is university property. So he can give you that we will not fund outside. You should live in dormitory. So that we don't know for type 1. But for type 2, you will get 12 million Korean won per year. It is like almost 1 million Korean won per month. And it's...
Can you convert into rupees and tell us so can we have a real feel for it?
I will start in Google how to convert. But I'm telling you, 1 million Korean won in Korea is a huge amount to stay in a flat. So don't worry about
the... It to almost 66,000 Indian currency. Mostly.
64. Okay. Now I think 64.
Right.
Okay. It's a 64.
I cannot be accurate. Yeah. So that's fine.
Yeah. Yeah. But nearly about 63. Yeah. Right. It's your.
Yeah. Yeah. So don't worry about the house expenses. Yeah. It's more than sufficient.
That is more sufficient.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. So if there is any one query, so you can ask. Otherwise, we will go for the vote of thanks.
I think again they are asking the age limit of Brain Pool Fellowship. So Brain Pool Fellowship, I have told earlier also, since it's started in 2021, most of the rules we still don't know. But if I will connect with the KRF, Brain Pool, if it is similar to the KRF, so when I have applied, it is well written, like after completing PhD, 5 years. Like it's just a 5 year duration after completing PhD. If you have complete that 5 year duration, you can't apply for Brain Pool.
So after completion of your PhD, within 5 years, you can apply
five
for.
Yeah, yes. Yeah. But so for Brain Pool Plus, time. There is no duration.
Yeah.
Right.
For Brain Pool Plus, you can apply. You should have at least 5 year experience for Brain Pool Plus. But for Brain Pool, you can apply within 5 years of your PhD, the finishing PhD.
Yes.
So thanks. For the joining today for KRF and BP session. So our next session is ISRK interactive session is for the university and professional funded Brain Korea Fellowship. So it is on 27th March. So stay tuned for more information. Now I would like to invite Dr. Supriya Patel. She's an assistant professor in Sejong University. Dr. Supriya Patel, can you start?
Yeah. Hello, everyone. Myself, Dr. Supriya Patel, currently working as an assistant professor in Sejong University. So it's actually good information on the behalf of ISRK. I would like to thank all the speakers of today's session, namely Pooja Rawat and Mohammed and Monu Verma for their valuable time and inputs on brain pool postdoc positions. Last but not least, I would like to thank all the participants for joining us today's session, and also thanks to Prashant. For more details of such sessions, please join us on ISRK social media platform, and soon we will upload this video on YouTube, so it will be very beneficial for all the participants and other students also, and researchers. And thank you very much, and all the best for your bright future.
Thank you,
Dr. Patel.
Thank you
very much for joining today's session. Bye-bye. Have a good day.
Hello, Dr. Manu. I have a small query.
Yeah, please go ahead.
So currently I'm doing my PhD and I'll be completing in a couple of months. So is it possible to apply for BP+? So am I eligible for BP+ program?
So for that, you need to have first complete your PhD program and then apply, mm-hmm. because we never know what is the defense time and what is your application due date. So for that, before your application due date, it's better you complete your PhD program.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Who can please end the meeting?